So remember the NFT situation. For anybody who doesn't know, I'll catch everybody up. There was a TV show about the Bored Apes that was being made. And Seth Green was one of the people heading it. But tragedy struck. The unspeakable, the unthinkable happened. Seth Green fell for a phishing scam. And the person running the scam stole all his apes. So he no longer owns the apes. And the person that owns it has responded. And we have a recap. Watch this. Yep, he's responded. So we got another episode in this story. Let's go and take a look at it. It got kidnapped. You kidnap a monkey and you put him in your house and you're like, you can't leave the house anymore. You can't record. You can't go to movies anymore. You can't watch. You can't be a movie actor. You're going to have to be a monkey in my garage.
There have been plenty of fails surrounding NFTs, an environment that, again, is rife with crimes, theft, cons, schemes, you name it. But what makes Seth Green's circumstance somewhat more special is that he had a lot riding on his stolen NFT. He was making a show off of his Bored Ape NFT. And with Bored Ape, because the rights to the IP stay with the NFT itself, if you lose the NFT, you lose the rights as well. And so as of this moment, Seth Green's show is halted, essentially, until he can...
It's not halted, it's kidnapped. It's been kidnapped. That's what it is. It's so dumb. I know.
Find a way to get that NFT back if he does manage to get it back. As for the timeline of events, well, on May 16th, 2022, Seth Green suddenly tweeted at Darkwing84, "Hey friend, can we chat? DM me, please." It was around this time that Seth Green realized that his NFT had been stolen.
Got kidnapped.
And then the scammer had sold the NFT to Darkwing84, who bought this NFT without knowing that it was in fact stolen, or so Darkwing84 claims. The following day, on May 17th, 2022, Seth Green sort of announced this situation. "Well, friends, it happened to me. Got fish and had four NFTs stolen, including the Bored NFT that his show was going to be based off of, and try to bring attention to Darkwing84. Looks like you bought my stolen ape. Hit me up so we can fix it. Some fellow NFT bros wish Seth Green the best. Hopefully you can resolve this without taking a loss." Seth Green responded with, "That's the goal. Only the ape sold and I'm trying to reach the buyer. We both got scammed." No, Seth, I'm pretty sure just you.
Well, they did both get scammed because both of them paid real money for a JPEG. I think that's accurate. They did both get scammed, but I think Seth got scammed a bit more than the other guy. Yeah, you got to keep in mind. Yeah, they both did get scammed.
Got scammed. I mean, first of all, if you're partaking in NFTs, you're all getting scammed. Let's face
That's
it. You can
kind
of feel Seth Green's desperation as somebody tweeting at him, "Seth, I have information that will lead to Darkwing84's capture and conviction."
Oh,
clearly a joke was met with this response. "Not clear they did anything wrong, but if you have any info, please DM me." And then this guy just burned him by saying, nah, man, I was just making fun of you, and just instantly ratioed Seth Green pretty hard here.
Seth Green
kind of played off, but yeah, people are not sympathetic towards Seth Green.
No, because everybody fucking hates this shit. It's fucking annoying. I wanna know what happened. I think this is funny. Shit's so stupid. I know. It's like, imagine this, right? You got people that can't afford real food. Like, they can't afford real food. Like, there's people that, like, if they want to get food, they can't because they can't afford it. So they're hungry. But, like, this is what's going on. This is it right here.
Who should have known the wild, wild west landscape he was getting into. And the fact that he's promoting this stuff is just not sitting well with people. Seth Green further explained that it was a scam, GutterCats clone site that fished him into giving up his NFTs. Now, the defense that Seth Green is trying to make is that, well, the IP doesn't technically belong to the person who bought the stolen NFT because the art was stolen. A buyer who purchased stolen art with real money and refuses to return it is not legally entitled to exploitation usage of the underlying IP. It'll go to court, but I prefer to meet Darkwing84 before that. But Seth Green is thinking in terms of traditional copyright laws, whereas with NFTs, this unregulated landscape, Yacht Club has defined that with Bored Apes and their NFTs, basically the person who buys the NFT, and if there's record of that on the blockchain, that person also owns the IP, because the IP is attached to the NFT itself, which Seth Green no longer owns after that.
Well, that's part of the value of it, right? Is because if you own something, the entire value of like a lot of this like NFT and blockchain stuff is the idea of true ownership of something that people can't take away from you. So to the extent that the Bored Ape Yacht Club can just take the NFT away from the guy or take the IP away from him, there's no value of what it has in the first place. I want to finish this video because I'm very curious, okay? We have an active kidnapping situation. You understand that, guys? I think some people don't understand the gravity of this situation. Multiple apes have been stolen, and you guys aren't praying at the problem. Like, oh yeah, let's get back to celebrity drama. Oh, celebrity drama, bro. This is an act of kidnapping.
Fished and then sold to Darkwing 84, who's officially the buyer of the NFT, and the blockchain shows that he's the owner of the NFT and therefore the IP as well. But Seth Green insists that if this were taken to court, things would look favorable for him. Precedent setting debates on IP ownership and exploitation, having spent 18 years studying copyright and the industry laws. I'd rather meet Darkwing 84 to make a deal versus in court. We can prove the promise of ape community. God, it's just people.
I wonder like what that conversation would be like. It's like, hi, I'm Seth. Oh, hi, I'm Darkwings. So where do you live? Guy's like, Russia. He's like, okay, all right, well, I'll see you later. Yep. That's about it. Yep. We're done.
Hear how ridiculous they sound when they're promoting NFTs. It's so cultish, the way they speak almost. But again, if you go to the Bored Ape Yacht Club website and look at their terms of service, it states right here, commercial use. Subject to your continued compliance with these terms, Yuga Labs LLC grants you an unlimited worldwide license to use, copy, and display the purchased art for the purpose of creating derivative works based upon the art. And
even that's clearly... No. I think that he read it wrong. If you go back and you read what he says... Pretty much like what this is, and is the ownership is mediated entirely by smart contract through your network. So they grant you subject to your continued compliance implies that this can be removed under certain exclusions.
The purchased art for the purpose of creating derivative works based upon the art. And even more strictly, if you read section one, you own the NFT. Each Bored Ape is an NFT on the Ethereum blockchain. When you purchase an NFT, you own the underlying Bored Ape, the art, completely. Ownership of the NFT is mediated entirely by the smart contract on the Ethereum network. At no point may we seize, freeze, or otherwise modify the ownership of any Bored Ape.
It's crazy because like that sounds pretty fucking definitive. I guess like the only situational word there is purchase. So in the situation that something was not technically purchased, then it would technically like under that logic, it would not fall under that category of ownership. So because Darkwing purchased it from the scammer, Darkwing did purchase it and technically did follow the rules. The scammer might not have owned it, but he purchased it. So theoretically, he still owns it under the language that they used.
According to what lawyers are saying, the only legal precedent that Seth Green could pursue is if it turns out that Darkwing 84 purchased the stolen NFT knowing that it was stolen, but
that's
if
not
he
in
didn't
rules.
Know that it was stolen and he bought it thinking it was just another NFT and genuinely had no idea that theft occurred, then he's in the clear. As stated by intellectual property and technology law professor Eric Goldman here, ordinarily bona fide purchasers are legally protected if they buy an item not knowing that it's a hot item. Now, there's been a new development where the person who bought the stolen NFT, claiming that they didn't know it was stolen when they bought it, has responded to this whole situation.
Here we
go. Spoken to news outlet BuzzFeed News, who prominently reported on
this. Why the fuck did BuzzFeed get an interview with this guy, and I didn't get to talk. I tweeted at him. He didn't fucking say anything to me. This is bullshit. I'm getting finessed by BuzzFeed.
Whole situation, they reached out to this individual and got their take on everything going on, how they plan to proceed from here, what their next course of action will be. Do they plan to give the NFT back to Seth Green? Well, the headline here tells you that Seth Green won't just be able to beg for Darkwing 84 to give the NFT back. He will either not return it and just keep it for himself, or he will likely ask for some kind of deal, compensation, to buy the NFT off of him and whatnot. But
now, if he really wanted to do something special, what he would do is he would take the NFT and then he would commission artwork done of the guy in like cuck porn. Of the NFT monkey in actual cuck porn with other NFTs to completely ruin the image of the monkey and devalue it for all commercial reasons. That's what I would have done. Because that could, no, think about it. Think about it, because it would destroy the image of the NFT. Yeah. Yeah. What the fuck, Asmon? Bro, if you, listen. If you put me on the case, I'll figure something out.
Just in terms of out of the kindness of his own heart, the owner of Seth Green's Stolen Bored Ape said they have no plans to return it. Uh-huh. The owner requested that BuzzFeed News put them in touch with
really
Green.
Bad stuff.
Darkwing 84 is leaving the door open to have some kind of discussion or negotiation as to how this NFT could be returned.
$1 million. $1 million. Oh, it's okay. I think that's reasonable, right? I mean, the guy's trying to run a TV show. $1 million for their lead actor? I think that's pretty reasonable.
To Seth Green, but it certainly doesn't seem like Darkwing 84 is in the mood for charity. I mean, he spent $200,000 on this NFT. He'll likely ask for at least that amount of money, if not more.
$800,000.
I would imagine the reason Darkwing 84 got into NFTs, aside from, I guess, the potential enjoyment of collecting these things that, in my opinion, have no value, is making money on the side as well. These NFTs are essentially investment opportunities with a hope that you can buy an NFT at a lower price than the much higher price that it could potentially sell for. That's the gamble you're making if you're looking to...
That's not the gamble you're making. That's the entire business model behind them. They're thinking... Oh, I bet I could find somebody dumber than me. And then the next guy buys it. Oh, I think I could find somebody dumber than me. It's almost like, it's like Highlander in a way. Where like they keep trying to like find the most powerful person who's like the dumbest possible, who will spend the most money for a JPEG. There can only be one. There can only be one owner on the blockchain.
Profit off of NFTs. But yeah, it was discovered that the individual who bought Seth Green's stolen NFT is an Australian surgeon with a side hustle. And this individual insisted that they bought the NFT in good faith and conceded that they have no plans for the NFT, including repatriating it to Seth Green. Seth Green.
That's good. So. The Australian, he's sitting over there on the upside down part of the world, sipping on that Foster's, you know, actually probably not at the same time he's doing surgery. Hopefully not. And, you know, just kind of chilling and, you know, he's got a new monkey, right? That's all there is to it. Yeah.
Since tried to negotiate the return of what he called his kidnapped. And I've already shown the numerous attempts that Seth Green made through Twitter to try to get in direct contact with Darkwing 84. Speaking to BuzzFeed, Darkwing 84 expressed that he'd be happy to chat with Seth Green directly. Woke up and have seen this craziness. Please put him in contact with me. So I'll be very curious to see how this situation develops, whether Darkwing 84 will negotiate with Seth Green or whether he'll ultimately be like, I like this NFT, I'm gonna keep it, and there's not much you can do about it.
Oh my god,
if that happens,
man,
will Seth Green go as far as taking this to court and turning this into a whole circus? And does he actually think he has a good chance of getting it back? I mean, he agreed to the terms that Bored Ape Yacht Club set, which is that copyright follows.
Dude, I really hope that they go and they take it to court. I hope it goes to court, man. I really do. Because if it does, just like, imagine like having a jury. And like, can you imagine like a bunch of like, you know, like a 48-year-old like mother of two, and she's like having to hear about like these like NFTs, and it's like a stolen and kidnapped monkey, but it's like not a real monkey. It's like a picture of a monkey, but it's like not painted. It's like on the, you know what I mean? Like, yeah, that's just, oh my God.
the NFT itself, whoever owns that NFT.
Court content.
So unless
Seth
Green can prove definitively that Darkwing 84 either knew that the NFT he bought was stolen or that he was somehow in on this scheme, it doesn't really seem like he's going to be able to take this case very far. Beyond going by the pseudonym Darkwing 84, also goes by Mr. Cheese. Mr. Cheese uses the Twitter handle Dwerty, and you can see that Seth Green is trying to reach out through this Twitter account as well, given that Dwerty here is actually followed by Seth Green as of recently.
There you go.
And when Mr. Cheese was asked by BuzzFeed what his plans are for this NFT, this is the quote that was provided. "I have no plans for the ape. As you can see, I have been collecting for a while. I bought it because I liked it. It wasn't a cheap buy either and was not marked as suspicious, so I bought it in good faith. I'm happy to be in contact with Seth to chat about this." As for why he's been seemingly ghosting Seth Green on Twitter, it would seem as though that may not have been intentional. Mr. Cheese claims they never checked their Darkwing 84 account. They have since requested that the actor DM them. Green now follows Mr. Cheese's Twitter handle. And you can in fact see in the responses of this tweet by Seth Green that Dwerty has reached out saying, "Please DM me." And Seth Green himself has actually confirmed that they've gotten in contact via this tweet posted on May 25th, 2022. "We have connected. Thank you for the help."
Oh my God.
Where those discussions have gone and where they're at now,
thank
obviously
God.
That's hard to say.
It's
Seth
okay.
Green still hasn't spoken about that and whether
they've
come to some kind of accord. I don't know how this is going to develop, but I'd imagine Seth Green will eventually find a way to convince this Darkwing 84 fellow, this Australian surgeon, to sell back the NFT to him. I would imagine Seth Green will be able to plead enough or strike enough of a good deal for Darkwing 84 that he'll eventually...
You guys think it's a publicity stunt? There's a good chance that it could be. I don't think that that's the most likely outcome, but there's a good chance, maybe it could be a publicity stunt. The guy could be doing it all for money. He could be trying to, make him look bad and all this stuff, trying to sell the IP. The thing is that, I said this before, is that regardless of if it's a publicity stunt, it makes NFTs in the value of the average person less important and less valuable. Because if you can just have something like this stolen from you and there's no real regulation to try to get it back or anything like that, I feel like a lot of the value that NFTs and things like this have is like very clearly perceived value. Like this is something that people think is worth a lot of money. So if people find out that it's not worth a lot of money, then it's not worth a lot of money. It's completely decided by the public. So I feel like this whole fiasco has devalued NFTs tremendously.
Be able to get the NFT and in turn the rights back, and the show will be able to move forward, as dreadful as that sounds for me personally. Hell, if Darkwing 84 wants to get real crazy as the IP owner now, maybe he can license out the IP to Seth Green and say, "Hey, you can make this show,
royalties.
But, you know, I'm going to have to be involved in some way. You're going to have to pay me some royalties." I don't know. You could really go that route, though I'd imagine maybe Seth Green might, you know, engage legally if such a proposal were to be made and there was no room for negotiation. But even if the NFT sees a safe return, Seth Green's reputation has certainly been tarnished. He's kind of become the butt of NFT jokes. There have been plenty of situations in the past that highlighted the folly of engaging with NFTs and what an unregulated wild, wild west, dangerous landscape this can be. Again, right.
I think that's my favorite part about it is like you have these like, all right, we'll go and we'll look at the trial. Okay, guys, listen, guys, we're about to see Amber Heard go to jail. Thank you for reminding me. Okay, we're about to look at it. She's about to go to jail. She's about to be done. Okay, y'all ready for this? It's about to happen. Just another bait. Nope, this time it's going to be different, guys. This time it's going to be different. I love how these guys think that like in an unregulated free market, they're going to be the ones that are successful. That's what I find to be the funniest thing about it, is like the ego about it. It's like, oh yeah, I'm going to be the one that's successful and popping off and doing super well in this like unregulated free market. But it's like, actually, you're just a fucking idiot buying pictures of monkeys. It's just so stupid and naive, man. Oh my God, it's bait? Nope, they said it's an update. People in chat said this one's going to be an update. Let's see the update. Here we go. Let's go. Let's see it. Let's get it. I'm ready.
So if you want to synchronize your watches, the jury deliberations just hit 8 hours. And of course, anything new in that room or in that courthouse, we will take you in there to see what they're up to. A question earlier today reflected on the verdict form. Might be some foreshadowing of issues they're dealing with. So you also know that there is a counterclaim in this case. Amber Heard brought that against Johnny Depp. And the core facts in that relate to statements made or attributed to Johnny Depp that called her a hoaxer, basically. That she's written this article, and that has got him excited because those things didn't happen. But because he called her a hoaxer, or his people called her a hoaxer, that caused her damage. That's the parameter for that. Let's listen to some of her testimony as she talks about the aftermath of the Adam.
No, we're not. We don't got an update yet, okay, guys? I'm sorry to say, as much as I'd love to see it, we're not going to get it quite yet. Here we go. Who the hell said update? Somebody who's being stupid. I think that, like, listen, obviously this is going to go on a lot. It might even go on into tomorrow. And what we're going to do, guys, I hate to say this, but people that are spamming and like, this is a new update, you've got to see this, you're going to probably get permanently banned because it's annoying. Yeah, that's what's going to happen.
With scams, theft, schemes, cons. But Seth Green's situation here is one where a lot was riding on the safety of the NFT.
Of course.
If you will. And the fact that even the likes of Seth Green can get scammed. And the fact that a whole large-scale production can be halted because NFTs are so unregulated and so fungible, despite the claim that these are non-fungible. The fact that it's so easy to hack people, to steal from people, to scam people through NFTs, just makes a situation hard to sympathize with. It's hard to feel sorry for Seth Green, especially when he is touting nonsense like this, trying to justify the alleged benefits of NFTs when
asked... Wait, what's he saying?
What value does the NFT aspect add to the process beyond apparently making it easier for people to be scammed? And this is in no way whatsoever the first time people have collectively contributed to a fictional world. NFTs have zero relation to artistic collaboration. Seth Green's response reads like the standard justification that NFT bros tend to provide. Imagine owning the rights to exploit Papa Smurf, Brainy, or Smurfette individually while still remaining part of the Smurf collective. I'll ask once again, do these people hear themselves and how insane they sound when they string words together like this? It's the first decentralized ownership of IP with passionate fans telling an artist's creation story together. Well, the irony is that it's the very nature of that decentralized
Oh my god. Like, imagine owning Papa Smurf, like, exploit Smurfette. Yeah. Like, what do you... How can you be so stupid? I can't believe this. Like, how can so many people be so stupid? And actually, you know what? This is the same reason why people can be stupid about NFTs. Is the same reason why Cody makes bank and he might have a Lamborghini. Maybe it's a rental. It's probably a rental, but there's a chance that it's not. You know why the reason is? Is because they want it to be true. They want it to be true so much that they're willing to invest their own money into it. That's all there
ownership
is.
Ownership of IP that has allowed for the IP that you once owned to get stolen through an NFT phishing scam. And yet in the same breath, you're saying, oh, I will take this to court and I will prove to everyone that I own this IP, even though the policy of Bored Ape Yacht Club states you don't, based off of this decentralized ownership of IP landscape that you have chosen to partake in. Beyond Seth Green's tweet, we have a response from Dylan, who put it very aptly. Fan fiction, role play games, computer games, kids in playgrounds, daydreaming hell, robot chicken. People have been participating in world building and collaboration and artistic creation since the first cave paintings went up. Literally all you're citing is ownership and the potential to exploit and profit from the process by creating artificial scarcity where there doesn't need to be, by turning art into investment opportunities for not just people who are dedicated to investments, but trying to draw in the public into being like, hey, buy this useless digital receipt to a digital asset for...
Well, they have to do that, because if people realize that it's worthless, then all of their pictures aren't worth any money. So it's all about convincing people that it's worth a lot of money, so to create value. That's obviously what's going on.
Thousands, yeah, hundreds of thousands, millions of dollars, because you'll be able to sell it for even much more than that and really rake it in. I mean, mm-hmm. that's the only reason NFTs exist. As Dylan says here, NFTs have nothing to do with artistic or creative innovation. It's solely a new means to generate profit, mm-hmm. which as a scam is what it is, but it's insulting to try to dress it up as anything more. Thank you, Dylan. And you can see here that not many people are siding with Seth Green, judging by the fact that Seth Green, with 1.4 million followers, got ratioed by this Twitter user with only two.
Bro, imagine getting ratioed. Like, this guy's got 200 followers, man. And like, he's got some black and white fucking Facebook 2010 profile picture. It's just, oh my God. That's just sad.
220 followers. So even if Seth Green does get his show back, it's great to see the pushback. It's great to see that people are speaking out against the promotion of this ultimately dangerous, unregulated, and scam fest of a landscape. It's great to see that NFTs in their current shady and cynical form continue to be a stigma, a PR risk for anyone who partakes. You can see the celebration surrounding this happening to Seth Green, as it just further discourages people from engaging with NFTs, and it discourages this technology that has more cons and pros
really
from
bad.
Being normalized. 85,000 likes. This article announcing that Seth.
It's like, I love how people, they talk about how valuable NFTs are. And like, one of the big examples that they use for like how valuable an NFT is like, oh, well, if you want to have a concert ticket, you can buy a concert ticket and it's an NFT now. As if we've never had concerts before. Like, we've never had, like, there's never been a way. Like, for 100 years that we've had concerts, nobody's ever been able to, like, figure this whole thing out. Like, how do you have, like, how can you, like, do, like, a music thing where, like, people buy tickets? Like, can anybody figure this shit out? Like, it's been 100 years and nobody knows what to do. Yeah, it's a solution looking for a problem. Exactly. Holy fuck.
Green no longer owns the commercial rights to the NFT and announcing this whole situation where he lost the rights because the NFT got stolen. Uh-huh. Plenty of people posting memes like this where they're just turning Seth Green into the butt of the joke. Here we have another one with over 30,000 likes. And this is honestly not even an exaggeration.
We
when
saw
it comes
this
to how
one before, I'm pretty sure.
NFT bro sound when they're like advertising NFTs or promoting them or justifying them.
My favorite part is whenever they unironically get mad about people saying that they're going to right click and save the NFT. They're like, you can't save that. It's not yours. You don't own that. They're like, yeah, I do. It's right here. I have it. It's on my computer. They're like, no, that's not yours. See, you don't understand. See, on the blockchain, it says that it's mine. So it's because it's yours. It's not yours. It's actually mine. They're like, no, idiot. It's on my computer. It's my picture. It's my picture. There it is. Hey. And then somebody else below them, I've got one. I've got the same one. It's like, oh, you too, man? That's crazy. And then the NFT guy is just fucking blocking people, getting furious about it, man. I think it's amazing.
Memes like this with over 17,000 likes. People tweeting at him the famous meme of the Halo multiplayer announcer saying, bored, ape, stolen. And beyond that, you've got news outlets responding to Seth Green's claim that he'll set a precedent for NFTs in court, with headlines like, a bored ape lawsuit won't set the NFT precedent Seth Green wants. After the actor's NFT and licensing agreement were stolen, he suggested going to court to win back intellectual property rights. Not so fast, states news outlet Wired. And scrolling
second.
Down, you'll find their justification.
Oh, for a second.
Not so
never
fast,
mind. Never mind. I thought he had a different
news
shirt
outlet
on.
Wired.
I was going to make fun
down,
of
you'll
for
find
sure.
their justification, which is very similar to mine. Unlike many NFTs, bored apes come with a license to make personal or commercial use of your new primate pal. With the star missing, the Seth Green show will likely not go on, can't go on. And after reiterating the terms of service that...
Why doesn't somebody just make a NFT of Curious George and just make a show off of that? Yeah, I mean, because like, so basically, like, if that makes sense, right? Because like, it's like, this isn't the first time we've had... a situation like this. It's copyrighted, but I mean, obviously, like, it's not on the blockchain. So you have your own that's on the blockchain, and it says that you own it. Who cares about copyright if it's on the blockchain? You literally own it. There you go.
are stipulated by Board 8 Yacht Club. The article responds to Seth Green's tweet that not true. They don't own the IP because the art was stolen.
Yeah.
The response is incorrect. This latest ape affair illustrates the limits of the free, frictionless world promised by crypto
and
many misunderstandings around ownership. Again, there's an
I love it, dude. These little fucking baby dick bitch boys that sit in their mom's basement all fucking day, and these are the ones that, like, they had no, like, they've never, like, I grew up scamming people. It was very regular for me. And, like, whenever I got into WoW, I was like, oh, well, whenever I was a kid, this is what happened. And not me. No, it wasn't me at all. Absolutely not. I was scamming people as a kid. This is what happened, is that I got into World of Warcraft, and I thought to myself, I think free markets are great. I'm a libertarian. I completely believe in free markets. And I took complete advantage of the market over in WoW. I completely cornered the market. I scammed people. I stole their fucking stuff. I gave them different prices for things. I fucked them over completely. And I did this for years. And then after a while, I thought to myself, you know what? Some of these regulations kind of make sense. You know, you can't really have a free market. I mean, it's not really going to, this is not really going to work, because you have people that fucking scam this shit and it just doesn't really work out. Yeah, it's just crazy to me, man. And then you stop scamming. Well, no, I didn't stop scamming. It was just a different viewpoint. Yeah, mom's, isn't that ironic? Well, living in his mom's attic. Yeah, I live in my mom's attic, not the basement, okay? I'm literally above them. And so, yeah, listen, all I'm saying is, like, these are people that have never done any sort of, like, they've never been successful in anything in their fucking life. And they think that somehow, in a completely free market, they're going to win out over everybody else? No, you're not. You're a fucking loser. You're not going to win out over anybody. And that's what happens.
Irony to these NFT bros not realizing the double-edged sword that is the decentralized, unregulated nature of the NFT landscape. And when they get burned, suddenly they start invoking the law. Except with Bored Ape specifically, the way rights are tied to the NFT makes the apes licensing scheme a whole different animal. And with how the situation played out, Wired insists that a lawsuit over Green's ape could set a meaningful precedent, but it wouldn't be the kind of precedent that Green seems to expect. If Darkwing 84 took Green to court to prevent him from moving forward with White Horse Tavern, they would likely prevail. Green's only real hope is to steer clear of litigation altogether and settle this quietly.
The best thing that he can do is try to threaten the guy with litigation and then assume that the guy doesn't want to deal with it. That's what it is.
The world that he has been robbed and crowing about going down in legal history is making such a possibility increasingly remote. Next time you think you've got the trial of the century on your hands, please talk to your attorneys before you talk to Twitter. And here's the cherry on top to all of this. This last paragraph highlights how Seth Green was very flattered by people reaching out to him, how he was encouraged by people reaching out to him saying, we've got to do something about this. Except NFTs are so rife with scams.
Yeah, we've got to solve this problem. I mean, you know, like, we've got a bunch of problems in the world. There's like a climate change, pollution, the oceans, you know, like animals are dying in the ocean, poverty, you know, there's like the fucking military industrial complex. And then also you have on top of that, more important than any of those, NFT values. Yeah, it's the NFT stuff. That's what really matters, guys. That's what it really is. That's what it's about.
That it could very well be that these people reaching out to him are actually scammers, pretending to be his friend, pretending to be supportive so that they can scam him again. There's a good chance that many of those concerned souls were fraudsters themselves. Once the cryptoverse knows you've been fooled once, you're likely to be besieged by bad actors hoping they can fool you twice, offering to help you recover your NFT for a fee. You can see the clever lengths to which hackers and NFT thieves will go.
Oh, we used to do that with people's accounts. And Jeff and I, we do the good cop, bad cop thing.
To scam other people, and it just happens all the freaking time. And Seth Green's situation is far from the biggest NFT heist. I've reported previously on heists that have led to hackers stealing hundreds of millions of dollars worth of cryptocurrency. So I guess what I'm trying to say here is, regardless of whether Seth Green is able to move on with this NFT show, regardless of whether he gets the NFT back and manages to resolve the theft situation amicably, it doesn't change the fact that he's only contributed to further tarnishing the NFT name.
That's what I've said the whole time with this whole situation. Is this whole situation just completely pokes a massive fucking hole in the NFT bubble? It's a massive fucking hole. And by the way, guys, can we get some hearts in the chat for the mods? Can we get some hearts in the chat? Like, my mods are gods. Let's be honest. They're amazing.
They contributed further to stigmatizing them by showing just what a shit show it all is. All the criticisms and concerns surrounding NFTs, he's only amplified that further. He's only made NFTs that much more of a laughing stock. He's only shined a spotlight on why NFTs, with their current implementation and intent, have no place in society, frankly. In video games, in society. If you're encouraging people to partake in NFTs despite what's happened to you and what's happened to so many people and how often these kinds of scams happen, at that point you're just being greedy and selfish and inconsiderate. If you truly wanted to benefit art, you would let art stand as art instead of investment opportunities for the public.
Well, that's all they are. I think that, like, again, most people, I think most people generally take something like Bitcoin or whatever a little bit more seriously. But a lot of people don't take any of this other stuff seriously at all, whether it's any of this just in general bullshit. People are tired of it. They don't want to see it. They're not about it. Bitcoin, not crypto. Yeah. Like, I think that, like, you know, if you're going to invest in, like, Bitcoin or, like, Ethereum or something like that, you can make an argument that none of it has value, but you're at least investing in something that has at least a history, right? With this NFT stuff, oh, my God. Oh, my fucking God, man. This takes us to extremists, though, especially regarding any new tech. There's always, this is what NFT enjoyers love to say. They love to say that you just don't understand. You just don't know what I know. We are so enlightened. We're going to understand it. Now, you're not going to make it, but we are, and we're going to be on yachts whenever you guys are living in slums. That's right, guys. Yeah, they're going to rule the world with the blockchain. That's the way it goes. And I'm sorry, guys, but that's life. Yeah, that's all they say, is they say that, yeah, they're like, oh, well, you don't know enough about it. You need to know more about it, implying that people don't know enough about it to draw a conclusion.
To get scammed from, you would not create artificial scarcity where there shouldn't be for your own benefit.
White screen? Wait, what's the white screen? What do you mean white screen? There's no issue? Okay.
This is just plain and simply greedy.
Smart Click Maps
is
bugged.
At the very least, that's one man's take on the latest developments surrounding the case of Seth Green's stolen Bored Ape Yacht Club NFT. That's a mouthful. Let me know in the comments below what you think about all of this, how you think this will all ultimately resolve, and what your general take is on NFTs in their current state and form.
I'm going to read
share your
some
thoughts
of these
in comments below. And to be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on YongYea. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.
Okay. All right, I gotta link you guys this video. I love these updates, man. I cannot wait for the next one, man. We've watched this guy many times, many times. You guys go ahead, give him a like, give him a follow, give him a sub if you like the video. I think these videos are great. He does a bunch of, like, news shit and everything like that. So if that's what you're about, that's what you like to see, I think that that's a very good channel for you to follow. I'll say that for sure. And a lot of his videos, I'll take a look at as well, okay?